In the library perspective, you can generate, upload, and export spectral libraries. For any library present in the library perspective, you can visualize multiple metrics. It will help you to understand its depth and coverage of the problem of interest. Also, the information presented will be helpful for DIA method development and optimization. We highly recommend generating spectral libraries directly in Spectronaut with the integrated search engine Pulsar. Every time a search is performed, Spectronaut will save the results, PSMs, for which run a search archive. These search archives can be used to generate new libraries without the need for searching previously processed runs from scratch. New run files and search archives obtained for the same sample type can be combined conveniently to generate new, deeper libraries. This option can be also used to generate a new library exclusively from combined search archives. This can be very useful when you would like to generate a library from a bigger number of raw files. You can simply divide them into smaller batches, generate a spectral library for each of them, and subsequently merge their search archives in one common search space. Importantly, search archives are also generated during direct DIA search, making direct DIA an important and convenient resource for the future search spaces generation. Let's generate a library. We will start by uploading data for the library generation. Pulsar will generate a spectral library from DIA or DDA data. If you acquire DDA data for the library generation, we highly recommend using both DDA and DIA files at the same time, as hybrid spectral libraries perform much better than classical DDA-based libraries. In the next step, we will select a FASTA file. If you perform a multi-species experiment, you can upload FASTA as one merged list of protein accession numbers from different species, or you can upload each of FASTA files separately. Now we can set up a specific search settings for Pulsar. We can select the enzyme used for the protein digestion, its specificity, expected length of the peptides, and number of miscleavages. Here you can also choose to perform a search with an unspecific digestion. In the labeling node, you can specify peptide labels, if you use any for your experiment. For example, you can specify SILAC labels. First will be the unlabeled channel, then the medium channel, and finally, the heavy one. In case you are performing a label-free experiment, you should leave all channels empty. The next node allows us to set up fixed and variable modifications that can be added to the search of your samples. Spectronaut will allow you to choose from a variety of modifications predefined in the database perspective, including user, custom modifications. Finally, you can select which ions should be searched for in your samples. Now, we can select search archives from the previously searched data, so our new library will be more comprehensive without the need to reprocess all data together. In the next step, we will select a FASTA file that will be used for the protein inference from identified peptide sequences. Here, you can select geo-annotations to further annotate data from your library. The next wizard page contains experiment-wide settings for library generation. For convenience, you can use a settings schema predefined in the settings perspective. Alternatively, you can modify them while setting up the search. Here, you can find settings related to MS1 and MS2 tolerances, identification thresholds, including PTM localization filter. Protein inference will be automatically done by the ID picker algorithm. Spectral library filters will determine which of the identified precursors and fragments will actually be used to generate a library. Note that the majority of the filters are not selected. as adding multiple filters might result in excluding a big portion of the identified precursors and fragments from your future DIA experiment. For the IRT calibration, Spectronaut will use deep learning-assisted IRT regression, where the deep learning algorithm is used to generate the IRT reference set. If you have labeled samples, we would highly recommend using the option to in silico generate missing channels according to the labeling strategy of your experiment. If you hover over the setting with your mouse, you can find a box with a short explanation of each of the options. A detailed description of each of the settings can be found in the software manual. The last page shows an overview of the whole experiment setup. Clicking Finish will start the experiment. As soon as the library is generated, it will appear in the library tree. Alternatively, you can generate a library from the results of other search engines, or you can import a ready-to-use library using an option below. Let's see what type of information we can read out for our library. First, the library summary will show the number of identifications at protein, peptide, and precursor levels. If you do not remember which library settings were selected for that particular library, you can select Library Settings Preview. Finally, you can select multiple visualizations to see the coverage of proteome achieved in your library. Among others, you can select here, for example, peptide length plot or protein coverage. You can also use readouts from the plots to further optimize your acquisition methods. To see detailed information on protein groups, precursors, and fragments included in the library, you can export the library in the TSV format over here.